Shalom, shalom, everyone. Good morning. I want to talk about something this morning about men and the relationship that they're supposed to have with God, the same thing as women. As me being the woman of knowledge, woman of wisdom, the holy woman, the other part of God. Because God has two attributes, right? He has the male attribute and the female attribute, okay? In one. The creator is only one. The creator stands alone. The creator doesn't need anybody else, okay? The creator has created many different things that lives inside of, right? But the woman is separate and the man is separate, right? But when the man and the woman becomes one, they'll become like the creator, right? The thing is that most men in religion are not fulfilling the I Am presence, okay? And women that are fulfilling the I Am presence of living in the Ruach HaKodesh, being holy and sanctified in the spirit of the Most High God and the Holy Spirit of God, because a woman has to have the I Am presence. The woman of knowledge and wisdom has to be with a man that's already mastered the Godhead, the I Am presence. He has to be holy, and the spirit of the Most High God should be upon him as well, meaning he's supposed to be the head of the house. The head of the house is a man that also has knowledge, wisdom, and has the understanding of God. When a woman is married to a man, she's not supposed to ask any other man to teach her or help her in any kind of way. It's supposed to be the husband. Why? Because the husband should have the full force of the I Am present. You understand the same way as the woman. You understand, a woman should not step out if the husband has the I Am present. She should not ask another man for help in any kind of way in the Word of God. If a woman has to step out and have a man help her in the Word of God, then he doesn't have the I Am presence. He's not well studied. See, people don't understand that in the Bible. When I read the Bible, I truly understand what it means. You know, the woman has to submit to the man, but it has to be a man of God. Submitting to him in many different forms, in a form of spirituality, spiritual growth, respecting one another, and many different things. And it's sad that men are created in the image of likeness of God, because the Most High God is a man, is a male spirit that has a male voice, but it has female attributes as well. Okay, so don't think that it doesn't. That's why I created woman and man. You understand? And people don't understand that men are supposed to be the head. He's supposed to be the head in many different forms, not the woman. There are men now that women are the ones with all this stuff, and men don't, you know, and that's the thing. When a man wants to be with a woman that's holy, that's righteous, is a woman of knowledge and woman of wisdom, yes, she can help the man, because that's the point. You help each other with different information. But the man's supposed to be above her. That's how it's supposed to be. You understand? A man has to carry the house. The man has to carry the things, not the woman. And that's the problem, that people are so religious and they're not spiritual, and certain men manipulate the Word of God to, you know, to fulfill their own desires or what it is. A man of God does not beat his wife. A man of God don't cheat on his wife. A man of God don't desire other women. A man of God truly loves his wife and honors her and respects her like he respects himself. A man of God has morals and respect and dignity for himself, you know, because God is class. You know, God does not destroy himself. The same thing, a woman, she has to maintain her body, work out, do exercise, eat right. The same thing as a man. Anybody that's working in the I Am presence has to live in this form. A man cannot live in the form of the world. You cannot be religious but not be spiritual, because if you're not living in the true form of godliness, in the true form of the I Am presence, then guess what? You will never be there, because that's what the creator wants. You know, it's sad to say that, right? That, you know, men that are created in the image and likeness of God are like totally far away from God. Women are more closer to God in some form, you know what I mean? But men, you know, you're the head of everything else, because you are in the image and likeness of God. Women come out of men. Men are the ones that determine the blood type, determine the female or the male that comes out, because it's the man that goes inside the woman. And the woman has the eggs and the eggs, you know, and all this other stuff. So, you know, people have to get it together sometimes in religion, because religion was based to be taught and to be taught truth and to live by the Spirit. Because God, whatever answer your wife has, God will show the man. You know, like, you ever seen, like, for example, there's certain things that I want to figure out, and I'll go, you know, and I pray or whatever, and God will show me or guide me to a TV or to a program, like a minister or pastor, and will say exactly what I want to know, right? But if you're married to somebody, you know what I mean, and that person is living in the full fulfillment of the Creator, you will get the message through the person you're with. Or whoever is teaching as well. You understand? So people have to understand that for you to live in the I Am presence, you have to believe in the I Am present. You have to believe in the Eternal Father, the Eternal Creator that created every single thing that has life. Because God is one with all. When you're worshiping outside of self, okay, is wrong, because that's what Yeshua taught people to meditate, fast, and pray to the Creator. To become perfected in the holy image and likeness of the Creator. That's why women have an X and Y chromosome. Why? Because you have male and female, woman and man. So it's supposed to be this way. And people are not understanding that. You know what I mean? That's why I say that there are certain men that want to be in a relationship with me. I said, no, I have to be with a man just like myself. The same thing. The same spirit that dwells within me has to dwell within the man. We have to believe in the same God. We have to have the same belief. We have to have same spiritual growth. And we have to do the same thing together. Because when a man does not believe in God, then he doesn't believe in himself. Because if God lives within you, then you know, then you are a dark person. You're living in darkness. You are a fallen man. You may look in the image and likeness of God, but you're not the son of Elohim. You understand? Because you are a fallen son of Elohim. So, you know, people don't understand that when you fall from the grace of God, you are a fallen man. So, you know, there's people that, you know, there's guys I see on Facebook all the time, you know, they got this, you know, knowledge. Yeah, you got book knowledge. That's fine. But you don't have spiritual knowledge. You don't have the true divinity of the oneness of God of what Yeshua came to teach man. You understand? Like Anna. Anna was a prophet, right? She went to Yeshua. You know, and many different things. I think it was also, there was another Rachel. I think there's many women that were prophets. And those are the women that need to be married to God-like type of men. Like, people told me I'm a prophet because of, you know, Zechariah, Ezekiel, and all this stuff. You need to marry a God-like type of man because you have certain types of abilities that God has given. So you are a woman of wisdom and knowledge. You have to only marry a man that is a full force of godliness. You understand? So it's just, that's how it works. You understand? So when a woman is a woman of God and a woman of knowledge and wisdom, is because God made her that way. You understand? Because she truly believes in the Creator. The same thing as a man. You know what I mean? It doesn't matter what skin color. It could be black, white, orange, or purple. You know, but people don't exist orange or purple. But I know I'm being kind of exaggerated. But I'm just simply saying that, you know, the man has to live in the full fulfillment of the body of God. And the same thing as a woman. She should have as much knowledge as him. But he should always be above. You understand? Because he is the man. And he is, you know, he's supposed to be the one that carries things. He has to not be jealous of his wife. He's supposed to embrace his wife. He's supposed to protect her. You know, he's supposed to do many things, not destroy the person that you're with. You understand? Knowing, loving the person internally for her spirit, mind, and body, not love her just for her physical appearance. You know, people, you know, nowadays I'm seeing with people and their relationships is that they don't live in the full form of God. You understand? They marry people for benefits or for body parts or for sex or for lustful reasons. You know, but where is a true love? Well, I love her because she has spiritual knowledge. I love her because the spirit is nice. She has the spirit of God. I love her because she likes taking care of her body. She likes eating right. You understand? And that's how they're supposed to be, man and woman. When you are married to each other, yeah, both have to be perfected. You understand? Not one or the other. You understand? The man always has to carry. The man always has to have more knowledge than the woman in some form. You understand? But not to go beat your wife or, you know, like, you know, people take the Bible. Well, you know, woman's supposed to submit to man and man's going to rule over you. No, the man is going to be more predominant than the woman, but not rule over her to beat the crap out of her. Say she got to shut up. She can't say nothing. No, that was never meant to be put in that term. I think that people that don't have the true spirit of God is not understanding what God's saying. That's why I say you can't read with the mind. You have to read through the spirit of God to teach you what God is trying to tell you. You understand? Because there's men that manipulate the Bible to their own benefit. and you don't mistreat your wife. You don't mistreat the woman that's loving you and taking care of you. You understand? A woman that's doing stuff for you, you're going to mistreat her. You're going to talk bad about her. You're going to let other people talk bad about the woman that you're with. You know what I'm saying? Because the only person that knows your wife better than you is God and you, because you're the one that sleeps with her. You're the one that wake up with her. You understand? You're supposed to be in her. Your spirit's supposed to be in her. Not meaning like, you know, God is with you in spirit, but meaning that you're supposed to be very spiritually connected to the person you're with. You understand that you can sense everything about them. Like, you ever sense that there's certain people that if you're with them, even though they're far away, you're still connected to them. Like, they can sense things of you. Or they can sense things around you. And that person protects you because he is your husband and you are his wife. You understand? Because you become married to the man through spirit. Meaning that your spirit and his become one. So when you die, you and him leave together. Because you're supposed to believe in the same God. That's why I say that people are not reading the Bible right. As when Adam and Eve, when he died before her. And she told Michael that she wanted to die also. She couldn't live without her husband. So she died. And they took her spirit. Because the man and the woman are supposed to believe in the same creator. Like that you both could ascend. Yeah, both can live together as a pair. See, that's what people don't understand, that when you have a true relationship with a woman, and she's a woman of God, and you a man of God, you won't be scared because you know you're going to a righteous kingdom. You're going to a holy kingdom. A man of the world will never reach that kingdom because you're living in darkness and you don't care to rise. You're living in destruction. You know, self-contamination. That's why I say that Revelation has been written almost 2,000 years ago. We're already in almost 6,000 years of creation because people change the calendar and the time. You know, they're always changing time back and forth, you know, 1 hour behind, an hour. People are just changing. They're not supposed to do all that crazy stuff. But we're almost 6,000 years in, and look at where mankind is. People destroying themselves, you know, you see all this crazy stuff going on. And I said, we're living in the end time, but there's people still that are living in the God-like form, though, as well. That's why God has not stepped in and done things anyway, either. Because, you know, there's always something that's going to happen in the world. You know, may eliminate certain people and keep others. Who knows what God may do. But it's just, the fact is, it's just perfecting yourself the way you need to perfect yourself in the God-like form. The I am present, man and woman. You understand? Like that you can become one. But not trying to be, you know, one way and, you know, tricking God and not trying to be like God and, you know, playing games with God, because God can sense those type of things. There's men that don't want to be godly. They just want to be with you because you look good. That doesn't work like that, because this is what happens. And angels come along and then things start happening spiritually and you get scared. It's like, what is it you're worshiping? Because God is not going to allow a woman that's fully consecrated to God, that wants to be perfected, to a man that doesn't. Live your worldly life. Leave a woman of God alone. Because if you choose to contaminate yourself, you choose to destroy yourself, you choose to sleep around with a whole bunch of people, you don't care about your body. Because a man that lives in the godly form cares about his body and his body parts. You know, there's diseases. There's, you know what I'm saying? And what man would want to mess up a relationship with a woman that's living in a God form? It's very hard to find people like that nowadays because the world is so messed up. You understand? That's what the men that are godly are wanting, a woman like that. They're not going to want a woman of the world, because they know women of the world are interested in money. You understand? They're interested in all this stuff. A man wants a simple woman. You know, simple means a woman that is not interested in things of the world. They're not interested in being married with a man just for his money. You're marrying him for all the attributes that he has and things that he can teach you. You understand? Because I said that the man is a teacher of the woman, and the woman also teach man. Teach him how to love him, how to nourish him. Teach him in many different forms and other things that you know that is applied to man as well. You understand? The woman helps the man and the man helps the woman. But in this world and age, men treat women bad. Women treat, you know, men backstab his woman. He'll talk bad about her and this and that and the third. She talk bad about him, and then he cheats on her. He sleeps with her. You know, it's sick. People don't have a healthy relationship. There is no God there. And there is no love. That's all selfishness. People are not living in the embodiment of the I am presence. And that's why I say it's very, very important to understand what God wants. Because if you're not walking in the godly image of perfecting yourself, because God gives you knowledge and wisdom. You think that all the stuff that I know that is self-taught, you think it's Angela? It's not Angela. It's God. God is the one that's teaching me how to teach myself. I give all the credit to God, because without God, I wouldn't be the person that I am. You understand? That's why I can self-teach myself through the spirit of the Creator. And that's what people don't understand. You know, like, I have more knowledge than most people because of God, and I humble myself in the presence of the Most High God. Because I wouldn't be. That's why I said God raised me, no one else. God's the one that's teaching me. Even the Bible, I don't read for myself. God is the one. The Spirit of God is the one that's teaching me. You understand? And that's what people don't understand. You don't believe in the Creator, then you won't be intelligent, because God is above everything. God is knowledge. God is wisdom. God is love of understanding. God is the counsel. God is the Holy Spirit. Ruach HaKodesh. God is everything. God is knowledge. God is above every single thing that exists. So that's why I say that the Creator is the one that teaches you how to become more intelligent. That is the only thing that God can do. Nothing else can do that in the place of God. That's why I say that I can self-teach myself, because God has taught me all these things. And I thank that every day. You understand? Many things that I know that I don't need to go to school for certain things, because the Spirit of God teaches me. And that's the beautiful part of having a relationship with the Creator. And I will never trade that for anything else in the world. Because God is first to me, and any man that I'm married to has to have that spirit. Because that spirit is going to guide the man to be where he needs to be and have a loving and healthy relationship with me. Not a man based on having sex or all these other crazy things that men are into. And, you know, it is what it is. But anyway, with that being said, shalom, much love, God bless, and I'll talk to you guys later.